Hello, I'm Nancy O'Neill. This week we'll explore breast lift surgery with Dr. Sessa, osteoarthritis with Dr. Hornberger, and find out more on the health benefits of dance from Tiana Ramirez. All right here on Aging Gracefully on Suncoast FYI. Continuing our cosmetic breast surgery discussion from last week, Dr. Sessa returns today to talk about breast lift surgery. Hi, welcome
Hi.
Back.
Thanks.
Welcome back. So let's start. How does someone know if they need a breast lift?
So I alluded to this last segment, but initially when you come to the for a consultation, I take measurements. So there are certain measurements that sort of lead me on to think that you would need a lift. Mm-hmm. And that main measurement is when I measure from the sternum or the collarbone down to your nipple. Now everyone's different, but it really depends on where your inframammary crease is. So if you look in the mirror, the simplest and easiest thing to do for somebody at home would be if you look in the mirror and you turn to the side, mm-hmm. and you can see the outline of your inframammary crease, and then you'll see where your nipple falls. If your nipple sits just below the fold or very below the fold,
yes.
then you need a lift. An implant alone will not lift the breast.
Interesting.
Yeah, it will not. The implant makes your breast larger, mm-hmm. but it will not raise the nipple.
Okay, so you basically need a combination of an implant and a lift.
Well, sometimes. I mean, if your breast is large enough, then you just get what's called a mastopexy or a lift.
Okay.
And that's just a procedure where I just raise your nipple up
okay.
to the desired position, and then it would have a more conical, more youthful appearance as it sits higher on your chest mm-hmm. and not very low. And is able to fit in a bra properly.
Okay, so
those
what's
are probably
involved?
The biggest reasons why people sort of look into this surgery
okay.
is they just can't really fit in a bra,
mm-hmm.
they can't really fit in clothing, or they're just unhappy with the way that their breasts look and they want them to look like they used to look.
Okay.
So what's involved in this surgery? There's a whole litany of types of lifts that you could get.
Mm-hmm.
So some of the types that you could get are just simple little nipple lift or something I call a crescent lift. And that's just something very simple where I just make a small incision at the top of your nipple from the 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock position, take out a little wedge of skin and just raise the nipple. A lot of times that's enough if we're adding an implant at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
That's enough to give a lift or the lifting appearance. If you need a little bit more than what that can provide, then we actually go around the nipple, move the nipple up. Now, some people sort of incorrectly say, oh, so you take the whole nipple off. No. When this surgery is done, you're not removing the nipple. The way that this surgery is done is you're actually moving all of the blood supply and the nerve supply, along with breast tissue, just higher.
Okay.
But when you do that, you actually make the breast smaller. That's the reason why we actually have certain incisions. In order to raise it up, you actually have to remove breast tissue. It's just the way that the surgery is performed. So, and sometimes to counteract that, we add an implant.
Okay, so can you have the implant and the lift surgery done at the same time then?
Yeah. So, in certain instances, if it's a real big movement, I'll recommend it's done in two separate stages. Just for safety purposes
uh-huh.
and to decrease the amount of complications that could potentially occur, it's better to do it in two separate surgeries. But in probably 90 to 95% of all of the surgeries where people come in looking for lifts, I'm doing it as a combination because most people
mm-hmm.
like the fact that you have one surgery and it rejuvenates the breast. When you do a combination lift with an augmentation,
mm-hmm.
of course, it could be used with silicone or saline, depending on what the person's preference is, as well as we'll have a discussion about that during the consultation.
Mm-hmm.
But most often, as I limit the size that the person can go to. Because if you think about it, theoretically, as the breast is lifted, it's made smaller. So if I'm also going to be putting an implant in now to make it bigger, it's counterintuitive to the tissues. So the larger you go, the higher the risk of complication. So I try to sort of keep people's expectations in line with, you know, you can't get a lift and have massive breasts at the same time. If they do want that, it's a two-step surgery, which is okay. And it's, you know, it's ultimately safer to do that, but it will ultimately get them what they want if we do it as a two-stage surgery. Okay. There's a higher degree of uncertainty when you do the lift with the AUG. However, that uncertainty is very, very small. I could probably give most people 95 to 98% of what they're looking for.
That's excellent.
By doing this combination surgery and safely.
Great.
Yeah.
How about bruising and swelling after this?
So the typical recovery for a lift with an augmentation, if it's just a lift or and I'm not doing an implant, typically that's just a few days of some mild discomfort, maybe a week out of work at most. If we're doing the combination surgery, a little bit more soreness, maybe 3-4 days, still about a week out of surgery, about a week out of work. But the real kicker is most of my patients are very active, so generally 2 to 3 weeks from intense workouts.
And they're back. Wonderful. Yeah. That's very doable. Great. Well, thank you again for being with us. We'll see you next week.
My pleasure.
Tune in to next week's episode for another segment on cosmetic breast surgery with Dr. Sessa. Aging Gracefully will return after the break.